special way for these young men and women who are to receive the sacrament of confirmation. All of us at this time pray in a special way for the coming of the Holy Spirit, who we believe comes to us in special ways at the Feast of Pentecost. Prepare ourselves to meet the Lord in the Eucharist today. Let us call to mind our own sinfulness, asking God for his mercy and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, our light and our salvation, Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, our gate of heaven, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, our hope of glory, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you. But whoever is made to suffer as a Christian should not be ashamed, but glorify God who does something in the world.
Thanks be to God.
New duties. I want to begin by
thanking your parents and grandparents and godparents, and all of those who have through the years shared their life, their love, and their values with you. It's very important for us to have good role models. And it's good for us to be able to look up at our parents and grandparents and godparents and to recognize that they are people of faith, people who have taken their duties and their responsibilities seriously. They've done all they could to pass on the faith to you. I thank also Father Luby and Father McCaslin and the various priests who have served you through the years, teachers of religious education, and all of those who have influenced your lives in a good and good way. They have done what they could to help you become fine Catholic ladies and gentlemen. And now you have to, so to speak, pick up the ball and run with it. 2 weeks ago today, I was privileged to be in New York. And just about this time of the afternoon, I was with 32,000 young people. People not much older than yourselves, people some your own age. 200 of them from our own diocese, with our Holy Father, Pope Benedict. In a wonderful service of music and praise, in which it was very evident that the Church here in our country is alive and well, and the Church is young. The Holy Father spent a good deal of time with the young people that afternoon, telling them, first of all, about six people who lived in New York State. Ordinary people who lived extraordinary lives, whom the Church recognizes today as saints, or people well on the road to sainthood. The people he spoke about were a wife and a mother, priests and sisters, the daughter of an Algonquin warrior, and a Mohawk mother, a Haitian slave, a Cuban intellectual. He spoke about St. Elizabeth Antecedent, St. Francis Xavier Cabrini, St. John Newman, Blessed Kateri Tekelika, Venerable Pierre Toussaint, and Padre Felix Barella. People from different walks of life, different cultures. Some came from distant lands and lived here in New York. Some were born here. There were no stereotypes. They came from all walks of life. They had different abilities, different education, different cultural aspects. But they had one thing in common. They were inflamed with the love of the Lord Jesus, and they wanted to share that love with other people. They wanted to be, in a sense, the Lord's disciples today. Followers promise of the Lord, we spread our sinfulness. For those of you who are receiving the sacrament of confirmation this evening, you too are the Lord's disciples. You want to follow his ways. You want to do what is right and just. You want your sense of generosity, your spirit of service, your desire for fair play. You want to be able to show others all of these things. And by doing that, you hope that you will be an influence for good. The people that I mentioned at the beginning treasured their Catholic faith, and they tried to share it with others. And you are those people today who bear witness to the good news of Jesus. And as young Catholic men and women, you have a special responsibility, a special challenge, to witness your faith and your belief at home, at school, at work, in the community in which you live. But it's not easy. And so you have to ask yourselves, how do I as a believer do that today? How do I show others what I hold is important in my life? How do I let others know what God means to me? Well, we all need heroes. And I think the saints show us the way. The saints that the Holy Father outlined in his talk. The saints that you have chosen as your special patron at the time of your confirmation. They show us what it is that is important in life. And once we bear witness to the faith, we're able to lead others out of darkness into wholeness of heart and mind. At Christmas, we celebrate the birth of Jesus. And the birth of Jesus shows us that God loved us so much that he sent his Son to live among us, to be one with us, just like us, in all things but sin. And we know that in this Christmas story, we know how certain people follow a star to find Christ. Christ who was the guide of light. Jesus tells us that God has found his place among us. And on Holy Saturday night, you'll remember how the church was in darkness, perhaps you were here. The candle was lit outside, this candle. It brought down the middle aisle, symbolizing Christ, the light of the world. And then when the candle reached the sanctuary, and the church was still in semi-darkness, the hymn was sung, reminding people of Christ the light. We were told at that time that Christ is the light which dispels all evil, washes guilt away, restores lost innocence, brings mourners joy, casts out hatred, brings us peace, and humbles earthly pride. This is the light of Christ at work. This is the way of the saints. This is the vision of hope. Christ's light beckons you to be guiding lights, guiding stars. And then the example of the saints invites us to examine four particular aspects of the treasure of our faith. Personal prayer and silence, liturgical prayer, charity in action, and vocations. We have an obligation to develop a personal relationship with God. We do it each day when we pray. Perhaps sometimes in familiar words like the Our Father and the Hail Mary. But other times when we just speak to God from the heart. Tell God what's going on in our lives. Asking for His help and guidance. But equally important to that time of prayer is a time of silence when we listen to God. Listen to what He has to say to us. And there's liturgical prayer, which we're doing right now. When we gather as a community, celebrate Mass, listening to God's Word, being nourished by His body and blood in Holy Communion. Whenever we celebrate Mass or the sacraments, like confirmation, Jesus is at work in us and in the community. We're joined by people all over the world in this act of liturgical prayer. And then charity in action. So many of our young people are extremely generous in trying to serve the needs of other people. There's a wonderful desire in the young to reach out and be of help to others. In service projects at school and key clubs. Perhaps in some work here in your parish. Or in the community at large. The church needs your efforts. The church needs you to reach out and help others. As you know, most of the church, even the Holy Father has said this in his encyclical letter, the church is most of the church when it preaches the Word of God, when it celebrates the sacraments, and when it reaches out in love and service to others in charity. And so I hope that as you receive the sacrament of confirmation tonight, you will recommit yourselves to prayer, to service, to doing what God expects of you, and to listen for His voice in your life. And finally, just a brief word about vocations. All of us in life, for most who are hearing my voice at this moment, that will be the vocation of Christian marriage, where you will live as loving husbands and wives, mothers and fathers, sharing your life and your love with each other and with those children with whom God blesses you. Always value the sacrament of matrimony. Always treasure and do your best to make your marriage your family, a holy family. Remember that it is from those families that vocations come, vocations to the priesthood, consecrated life. I am absolutely convinced that God is calling young men and young women in our diocese to priesthood and religious life. And if in the back of your mind that thought is there, don't put it aside. Don't close your minds or your hearts or your wills to that plan of God. Speak to Him from your heart and listen to the whisper of His voice in which He directs your life, your activity. You are the disciples of Christ today. And since you are His disciples, you need to embrace the vocation He gives you with courage. Be determined to be the best husband, wife, priest, or sister that you possibly can be. God looks for your generosity. He looks for your response. He looks for your love and devotion. For you are the disciples of Christ today.
Thank you.
sacrament of confirmation, let us turn to the Lord, presenting our prayers and petitions for people here and in the world.
For all the members of the church, especially the newly confirmed, that they welcome God's presence in their life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of every nation, that they seek peaceful justice and serene freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For farmers and ranchers who provide the world's food, that they receive a just reward for their labor.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For teachers and students nearing the end of the school year, that they find recreation and renewal during the summer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community of faith, that they take seriously their baptismal call to service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, you are true, your word, and faithful to your promise. Hear the prayers of your people who gather here this afternoon in the name of Christ the Lord.
Amen.
fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will be God for our spiritual life.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Lord, accept the prayers and gifts we offer in faith and love. May this Eucharist bring us to your glory. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we will always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. In his risen body, he plainly showed himself to his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, to claim for us a share in his own divine life. So with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
My son, my God.
Father, calling to mind the death of your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an everlasting gift to you, and enable us to share and inherit with your saints, with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the Apostle Martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we will light up.
Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, our Savior, Pope Benedict, our Bishop Robert, and all the bishops, with the clergy and the entire people, your Son and your to. Father, hear the prayers of the family you have gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children, wherever they may be.
Welcome into your kingdom, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come.
Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the Savior.
Thank you.
forgive us hope, that the glory that is in Christ will be given to the church, his body, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
Father, help your people to rejoice in the mystery of redemption and to win its reward. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.